allow ourselves to lessen efforts because racism and intolerance are still very much alive and, as reports show us, are in fact on the rise in Europe.
This study session is different from the other because this is a study session which we are celebrating the anniversary of 10 years of the Rexy campaign, and we target the city, and how you can see from our posters, the logo of our posters are Roma, 10 million Roma, 10 million European citizens. Why we choose this logo is that is the fact that the Roma are the biggest minority in Europe. And with this kind of campaign, we want to raise the awareness that still today in Europe there is anti-Gypsyism, and the racism and the xenophobia is related to the countries. And I hope that the young people with this campaign, the Roma young people, will show to all publicity that we are raising the questions, and that we the Roma, we are also human beings and we are equal like the others.
L'histoire de Ferip, c'est assez long à raconter. Au début, on avait beaucoup de problèmes, on s'est retrouvés à l'année 96 à Budapest. Alors, c'était la première activité internationale que je fais avec des Roms. Et pour moi, c'était découvrir quelque chose de nouveau, avoir les contacts avec des autres Roms de l'Europe. Et changer des idées. Il y avait beaucoup de motivation. Tout le monde voulait faire quelque chose, mais on avait trouvé quelques handicaps sur ça.
First, I knew about it as a university student and an organization that was organizing programs and trying to mobilize Roma youth in Europe. As a Roma university student, I followed their work, but not only because it was a great initiative, but also because it was one of the only ones. And of course, there were in Eastern Europe especially, there were scholarships for Roma, and I always missed the sort of network of these people. So Felipe is the first one who is trying to basically put us all together and trying to connect Roma students in Europe, which is having 10 years of experience of this work. I think it's going to be a very important actor in the next few years in the Roma movements, not only because there is a generation change taking place at the moment in Roma politics on the European level, and I think on the local level as well, but also because this is the only organization at the moment who has the background to act politically on the political level. I was a little bit disappointed, but to learn, for example, that in any youth-related issues that come up in European politics, there is a very little voice of Roma youth. So probably this is going to be the organization who brings them, who grows to the role of any other political big organizations now, like the European Roma Forum or the members of the European Parliament.
Il y a quelque chose qu'il veut changer. Ça sera à moitié. Et les personnes qui ne sont pas du tout d'accord avec les programmes, ils restent dans des cercles. On a gagné beaucoup de choses en ces moments. Parce que, au début, on avait beaucoup de problèmes pour commencer avec cette organisation. On avait d'un côté le problème d'être jeune. Et parce que bon, dans notre organisation sociale, être jeune, avant ça signifiait avoir pas de la possibilité de donner ton avis. De notre côté, on avait les problèmes d'identité. Parce que quand on s'est retrouvés tous ensemble, les Roms de différents pays, il y avait quelqu'un qui parlait romanais, et quelqu'un qui parlait pas romanais. Et au début, c'était difficile de se reconnaître tous comme le même peuple. Et aussi, il y avait beaucoup de femmes. Alors les femmes, il y avait un double handicap, être jeune et être femme. Et en ce moment, on peut dire qu'on a tous un sens d'unité, de peuple. On dira qu'on a l'essence de la Romipen. C'est une organisation qui est absolument indépendante, qui peut donner son avis sur ce qu'il veut, et on ne doit pas répondre à aucune organisation de personnes âgées, quoi. D'autre côté, c'est une organisation qui, il y a beaucoup de femmes. Et la preuve de ce progrès des femmes, c'est que le président de FERIP, c'est une jeune femme.
De plus en plus de jeunes Roms sont engagés, ont envie de travailler dans leur communauté. Donc il est important que des associations comme FERIP existent pour leur venir en aide, pour les soutenir, pour les aider à créer des projets.
To tell to the young Roma people that we are a community, a great community in all of Europe. Sintis, Calais, Roma people, that we have a common beginning. We are the same. We have the same blood, the same language with dialects, and we have to converse all of it with a good purpose. With a good power that I think we will accomplish it. And also to the non-Roma people, I think that the respect to the Roma people and the Roma people to respect to the non-Roma people, it's a quite important aspect to trust, to share, and one more time, to respect.
Ay, ahora que yo se lee. Los libros a mí me han engañado, los voy a tener que romper.
Well, I think I learned a little bit more about the local influences on Roma culture and how they are able to emulate, to mix together their own Roma culture with the culture of the countries where the people inhabit concretely. So, and I think an event like this is really a step towards educating both sides about people opening to each other and learning about each other.
I am expecting them to be very committed, like they are. I am expecting them to evaluate both education, but also our identity, which means Romani culture, language, and our cultural heritage. Because if you become very well educated, even if you get a good position, high level position on national or international level, but if you are forgetting your own identity, then there is no purpose anymore. We doesn't have any Roma anymore. You can be who you ever can and who you ever want, but it's not anymore Roma policy. This is why I am asking from the FERIP youth and all the European Roma youth to be very strongly committed into promoting their own people's rights, but also evaluating our past and our cultural heritage.
Thank you. in all cultures, in majority and minority cultures, the young people will always change system and they will always take their place. And to find a balance that you have to preserve your own culture and fight for preserving your own culture, and at the same time trying also to change some things. It's not easy. And so sometimes Roma women or Roma young people, they can feel that they are not only discriminated by the majority, but sometimes also they feel that they are not at all understood by their own community. So it's kind of a double challenge, and, but I'm sure you will make it.
First of all, I think that's very important that young Roma are taking initiative for themselves. What I see is that they are taking also responsibility for the Roma community. And I would say on the one hand it's good, because the ones I've seen are very competent and are also very competent for the whole community. But on the other hand, they should not forget that they are still young and should still keep a space for hope and not take too much responsibility for everything.
Since it started about 10 years ago or so. I mean, the difference is, first of all, that it's a youth organization at pan-European level, and there are not so many. And the second point, I think it's one of the most solid, long-lasting 10 years already, and well-structured, well-organized, and solid organization, I would say. Really representing the youth from European countries. What I would say related to the Roma movement in particular, I know that now we have a large number of young Roma, very well educated, well prepared, and able to take the lead and to work differently from their elder colleagues. And I very much hope that they will have a possibility in the coming, as soon as possible, to take the lead of the Roma movement. Because it's not to say that the elder people were not good enough. They did a great job. But now, I mean, it would be a pity if this generation of people who are better prepared, different, able to use the methods, the same methods as the majority, were not able to access quickly the possibility to lead there.
But what I see in my work every month, every year, more and more, there are young Roma people who are participating at the European level already in many activities.